Time for minor league baseball here on the show as we set our sights on the AA Eastern League. A critical one in store for us here. It's game one between the Bowie Baysox and the Flying Squirrels of Richmond. Into the box now, Mark Vincent. He'll get us started in this one under the lights. The 2-1. Pulled high in the air out to left field. Hayward is there and he makes the catch for the out. Into the box now, Mason McCoy, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one.
McCoy.
That nibbled the corner there, but missed 2-1. Game time temperature tonight, a comfortable 66 degrees at first pitch. 3-1.
Three ball, one strike.
The 3-1 pitch. And he lays off here, ball four, and he'll become the game's first base runner here with one away. So stepping in, Cesar Avila. He'll get to take his first cuts here. Back up the middle. And that's through for a hit.
The first baseman, number 22.
Standing in now, Ryan Ripken. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off. Got him swinging. Chased it well out of the zone, and there are two gone. Stepping into the box, Ryan McKenna. Great chance to drive in a run here in the early going. Line to the right side. A leaping try, but it's out of his reach and into the outfield. As he arrives at second without a play, as they jump ahead with a run scoring on the play. To the plate now, Ryland Bannon. And it's up to a 3-2 full count now. High in the air out to center field. Number 34 is there, and he'll make the catch to retire the side. Standing in, Jacob Hayward. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. And it's 1-2. Swung on and missed. Really fooled him that time for the first out. Stepping in, Joe McCarthy. One out, nobody on.
McCarthy.
And a changeup runs inside on him as he's got to back out of the way of that one.
That was a changeup, so there really wasn't any intent behind it. Looked to me like it just slipped out of his hand a little bit. That'll happen sometimes because of the grip of that straight changeup.
And that misses there, so he runs the count full now. Swing and a hot shot toward third. And that gets down and ought to be good for extra bases. And this will find the wall deep in the corner. And he'll reach second now with one away. Into the box, Stephen Padilla. Looked like the fastball got away from him there. It's ball two.
Looked like he just tried to do too much with that fastball right there. He overthrew it a little bit. That's pretty much the case when you airmail a fastball like that.
Nickname is there. Two down. And no tag at second. He'll head back there with two away now. So striding in, Gio Brusa, as he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield. Into right field, that's a base hit. And they're going to hold that runner at third base, as even with two away, they didn't like their chances there. In now, number 34, fouled off. Runners on first and third, two away. Hit down the third baseline. And this will be a base hit as they too will play to run in the first inning to tie up the ball game early. So now to the plate, Zach Houchins. Oh, and a half swing there on a pitch out of the zone indeed at strike two. In front of a fastball as this is ripped down the left field line. That's going to be a fair ball. One run is scored. Here's a second runner around third. He'll score easily as they extend the lead a bit. It's now a 3-1 game. At the plate now, Ryan Howard. Down low, two balls and a strike. Strike two on a well-placed changeup around the knees.
Hey, I love that pitch right there. Better execution after just giving up an extra base hit.
Fouled away. Hard hit ball to second. Right to him. Throw in time and the side is retired. Coming to the plate now, Taylor Davis. He'll get us started in the top of the second.
Hey, we're still in the early stages in this one. They're only down by a couple of runs, but it's really key for this leadoff guy to try to get on and get a big inning started.
Ball taken there, 2-1 now. Liner towards second, but this will be taken in at second base. Good positioning for the first down. Striding into the box, Jose Rondon. Okay. Bases are empty, one man out. Now a swing and a miss. He struck him out, and it's two up, two down to start the second. Digging in the switch hitter, TJ Nichting. He'll work on keeping this top of the second alive. And the cutter got him swinging. Strike three, and the side is retired. Stepping up now, Kian Wong. He's set to lead off the home half of the second.
One of the keys to securing a win, they want to keep the pressure on and try to build that lead as much as they can.
And a reach to his backhand, but he can't come up with it, and the leadoff man's aboard. And he's going to get to second now with nobody out.
Batting
at the plate, Taylor Heineman. Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball.
He might still be thrown off from that first inning, guys. He got knocked around pretty good, and that can be hard to recover from mentally sometimes.
The count now at 2-2. Fastball didn't miss by much, and it's a full count now, 3-2. And he takes ball four. So a good job out of the nine hole in getting on base as we go back to the top of the order. Digging in to try it again, Jacob Hayward. 0-for-1 for him here in this one. The 1-2. And now here's a ball hit pretty well out toward right center field. McKenna is to his left as he puts it away in the alley for the first out of the inning. And he'll move up to third now. Runners at the corners here with one away. Digging in for his second at bat, Joe McCarthy. He scored a run after stroking a double in his first at bat.
Yeah, he did a great job to go down and get that one his last at bat.
Taken high and deep to right. Going back is the right fielder at the track. Gone! To the plate now, Stephen Padilla. Now a drive out to the gap in right center. He threw first and hustling for second. And he'll pull into second with one away. Reed Love enters from the pen in just the second inning, so they'll hope to get some length out of him and have him stay out there for a while. Into the box now, Gio Brusa. A ball and two strikes now.
When I broke into the league, not many guys were throwing that elevated fastball with that much velocity on it. The game has changed.
Good swing on a tough pitch, and he'll stick around to see another one. Here's another 1-2. Swing and a soft liner. And he'll whip this one over to first, and he gets his man for the second out. Stepping in and ready for another shot, number 34, runner in scoring position with Sugan. A little bit outside, 2-1. And they set up away with the fastball, but it misses, 3-1. But this won't get over the second baseman's glove as he's got it to end the inning. New inning set to get underway, and standing in is the DH, Mark Vincent.
Lots of baseball left in this one as we're still early on, but you don't want to fall too far behind. They're already down by a bundle, and one of the things you want your leadoff guy to get on and set the table for the big boys to start driving in some runs.
Now at the plate, Mason McCoy. He reached on a walk in his last time up and later came around to score. The 1-2 is a swing and a miss. That's strike three. At the plate, Cesar Avila. He reached on a single in his first try. Fastball taken inside for a ball. 2-1 now. On a good pitch there. Had him stretching to get out there. And it's 2-2 now.
Man, that's another ugly swing right there. This team is just struggling so mightily to get on base. They've looked off balance all game.
Number 34 is under it, and he makes the catch for out number three. Bottom of the third now, and set to go is the third baseman, Zach Houchins.
Even though they're up by a boatload early on in this one, you can't get complacent and get lazy. They got to keep the gas pedal down because this team that they're playing can strike and score a lot of runs too.
Oh, he snares it. Ready now, Ryan Howard. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. The 2-2.
Got a full count.
Here's the two-seam fastball that bears in a bit too tight. It's ball four. Stepping in, Kian Wong. He'll try to follow up the double in his last at-bat with another big hit right here.
Well, he got a good pitch to hit last time up. Looked for it up in the zone and didn't miss it. Those are the pitches you only get maybe once an AB, maybe once a game, maybe once a week. So he certainly capitalized on it last time.
3-1. Hit back up the middle. He's got it. One there. On to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. Settling in now, Ryan Ripken, as we begin the top of the fourth. Half swing that time, but it's a full swing in the eyes of the umpire, and that'll be the first out of the inning.
Now
digging in, Ryan McKenna. An RBI double is what he was credited with his first time around.
And he's got to build off that last AB. He battled. Usually when you battle, you get in that swing mode. A lot of pitches, you'll swing at the rosin bag. I love the fact that he was able to work a double in last at bat. Let's see if we get more of the same right here.
Struck him out.
Now batting, the second baseman, Ryland.
The 1-2.
Two balls, two strikes.
swung on and lifted in the air to left center. Left fielder giving chase. He's there to make the play, and that'll retire the side. Digging in now, Taylor Heineman. He worked the walk and came around to score in his first trip in this game. The 1-1 home. Hit pretty well out toward right center field. Right fielder giving chase, but he won't get to it, and this should put a man in scoring position to start the inning. And he is into second base with a leadoff double.
The batter, the left fielder, Jacob Hayward.
In now, Jacob Hayward. Into the corner and slicing foul. No one out with a runner at second. And now this ball's lifted in the air down the right field line, but this will get back into the seats, so the count holds at 2-2. From the belt, the pitch. Oh, and they pulled a string on a good changeup there as he swings and misses, and he's set down on strikes for the second time tonight. Now in the box, Joe McCarthy. Already a home run and a double for him in this one.
The last at bat, Matty D, we heard this guy's a good fastball hitter. He got a fastball and didn't miss it. We'll see if they pitch him a little bit differently this time and mix in some off-speed pitches.
Got a piece. It's 2-2.
This pitcher's bringing it with some high velo. You better get that front foot down early and get ready, or he's going to throw it right by you.
Had to sit back on the changeup, and he did a good job to get the bat on that one. This pitch is popped up. McCoy is under it. Two gone. Next will be the designated hitter, Stephen Padilla.
The designated hitter.
Two out here and a runner at second.
Padilla.
Bouncer up the middle. And that's through into center field. Base hit. The throw to the plate. Oh, but it's offline, so the run will score.
Now batting. The first baseman.
Here's a look over first. And a dive, but he's back in. So now to the plate, Gio Brusso in the air out to right. And he'll get there in plenty of time to put this one away, and that ends the inning. So striding forward now, Taylor Davis hit it hard but lined out in his first at bat.
Yeah, Matty, it's always a little frustrating when you square one up. You hit a solid line drive like he did, and all you have to show for it is a jog back to the dugout. That can get in your head for a little while.
Takes this the other way to right, and that finds the outfield grass for a base hit. And this will find the wall right near the 347 sign. The relay, and he's able to hustle his way up to second as he'll reach here with a two-base hit.
The third baseman, number 13.
Into the box, Jose Rondon. Left side. And the throw pulls the first baseman off the bag, and he's safe at first.
Now back.
Striding in, TJ Nickteam comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. The 1-1 home. Strike two swinging.
One ball, two strikes.
Off the plate that time and a little high. It's even at 2-2. And a changeup swung on and missed for the first down. So the batting order turns over now and set to go. Mark Vincent. He comes in 0-for-2 thus far. Hit pretty well out toward right center field. Long run for the right fielder. He makes the catch, and the runner from second will tag and head for third. And he'll make it up safely to third, so they're at the corners now with two men out.
Now batting.
Standing in, Mason McCoy. And we'll see what he can do here with a pair of runners on base and two gone here in the fifth. Here now the 2-2.
3-2, two out, runner on first. Lots of possible outcomes on this pitch.
There's a drive out toward the alley in right center. And the runner scores all the way from first as they try and chip away at their deficit. That makes it a 7-3 ball game. Stepping in now, Cesar Avila. Bouncer to the left side. He's right there. Throw on to first gets him, and the side is retired. Ready once again, number 34. He's singled in two trips to the plate thus far. Grounder hit hard down the first baseline, and he'll take it to the bag himself for the out. At the plate, Zach Houchins, one for two in the ball game thus far. The 1-2 is looked at for ball number two.
Don't be shocked if he doesn't go right back to that same pitch. You could tell he jelly-legged him at the plate a little bit, froze him, but just missed his zone.
Got him looking with the fastball as that had some two-seam movement to it. Two gone. In now, Ryan Howard. He's 0 for 1 thus far. Swing and a shot hit down the corner, and he just couldn't keep that ball fair as it winds up a long foul ball. Ground ball sent back up the middle. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as the side is retired. Leading off the inning, Ryan Ripken, and they'll need him to get something going here.
This one doesn't look good so far, down by a boatload as we enter the middle innings. It's about time they get something going, and the last thing you want to do is fall behind where you have to score a bunch in the eighth and ninth inning.
Hot shot to third. Throw to first gets him, so the leadoff man's retired here to begin the sixth. Now at the plate, Ryan McKenna, one for two with a double on his line thus far. Popped up. Houchins over to his left. He's got it, and there are two down now. Coming to the plate now, Ryland Bannon. He flew out in his last at bat.
Bannon.
One and two now as that's in there at the knees. Pitch taken several inches below the zone, in fact. And now this ball's lifted in the air down the right field line, but this will get back into the seats, so the count holds at 2-2. And another foul ball. 2-2 one more time. And he struck him out, his eighth punch out of the ballgame, and that one ends the inning. Striding in once again, Kian Wong. He was a double play victim last time around.
Yeah, rolling into a two ball will eat at you for the rest of the game at least. So you know he wants to make up for it right here.
He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Up high. 2-1 now. This is hit the other way out toward left field. Avila comes in a few steps as he hauls it in for the first out. Digging in and looking for more, Taylor Heineman, who came across to score after doubling in his last at bat. Looked like the fastball got away from him there. It's ball two.
Listen, I'm not trying to make up an excuse, but this is this guy's fifth inning of work in this game out of the bullpen. Are you kidding me? Nobody goes five innings anymore.
Nick Dean is over to his right as he puts this one away. Two down. So the lineup flips over and digging in, Jacob Hayward. 0-for-3 with a couple of strikeouts for him to this point in the ballgame. And that misses off the plate and low, so it's 3-1 now. Joe McCarthy would be next. Now a rocket deep down the line in left. But that'll stay in the park as it's off the left field wall. The throw into second.
Now that the right fielder.
Blake now, Joe McCarthy. Swing and a miss as he pulled the string on him, 1-2.
Guess who tipped their hand? They were sitting all over a piece of cheese. He flew open on the front side.
Got him looking, and that ends the inning. Rafi Vizcaino is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number 7.
Number 90.
Into the box, Taylor Davis. He's 1-for-2 in this one.
It doesn't look very promising so far in this one as we move into the later innings. Down by a bundle, it's time to get some base runners and hopefully a long ball to get them back into this one.
And a good take there as they'll have a leadoff man aboard to start the 7th. It's ball 4. And 2-2.
Got to believe the pitcher's going to trust his defense right here. Look for something down in his zone to induce a ground ball double play.
Just staying alive, putting together a really good at bat here. Davis on at first, nobody out. And he got him. Ready for another chance? TJ Nickteam, 0-for-2 on his line thus far.
TJ Nickteam.
Now the 1-1 pitch. And he makes good contact there, but this is going to find the stands foul down the right field line. In the dirt. And he is in there. They couldn't get him at second. And costly as the runner will move into scoring position now. Struck him out. Struck him out again, I should say. His third punch out of the game.
Now that designated hit.
Stepping up to the plate, Mark Vincent. Swing and a miss, and it's a ball and two strikes here.
I wouldn't be surprised if he used his aggressiveness against him right here. If you're going to get a swing outside the zone, 1-1, might as well fish a little bit further.
Here now the 2-2. It is swung on and missed, strike 3. Christian Alvarado gets the call from the pen to take over on the mound and start the home 7th.
Number 77.
Bottom of the inning now, and striding forward the designated hitter, Steven Padilla. Two balls and two strikes now. And he takes ball 3, so it's a full count now. Gio Brusa will be next. Fastball swung on and missed for the first out. Next will be the cleanup hitter, Gio Brusa. He's got a hit in 3 at-bats to this point. 1-1. Alvarado a 25-year-old. He throws a four-seam fastball, a slider, a changeup, and a two-seam fastball. And he strikes him out as well. So make it back-to-back punch-outs here to the first two men he faces out of the bullpen. And he's a little too high with that one. Two balls and a strike. Not close with that one. It's way above the strike zone. Zach Houchins would be next if they can keep this inning alive. Hit out towards second. Fielded cleanly. And the off-balance throw gets him as he takes away a hit and the side is retired. Matt Caricini has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth.
Number 63.
All set for the start of the inning, and stepping up as the shortstop, Mason McCoy. Ready on two balls and two strikes. Here it comes. Started to go. Did he hold up in time? Yes, says the first base umpire. It's ball three now. Payoff pitch on its way. Now here's one hit in the air to the right side, and Wong will make the catch, one away. Digging in, Cesar Avila. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time. Now the 1-1 pitch.
Outside, that's the ball.
Nobody on. Grounded down the third baseline, but this is going to be a foul ball as that keeps things at 2-2. And the pitch.
You can certainly tell at bats like this one frustrate the heck out of a pitcher. But you got to find a way to stay composed and execute your plan.
He's set. Here's the 3-2. Popped him up. Brusa moving to his left. Two down. So now it'll be the four-hole hitter, Ryan Ripken. He was retired via the ground ball last time up. There's a swing and a high deep drive headed for the right field corner, and that's going to wind up hooking just a bit foul, so a missed opportunity there. The 1-2. This is lined to left, but he'll flag this one down toward the alley. Nearly trouble, but instead the inning is over. Of inning number 8 set to go, and that'll give way to the third baseman, Zach Houchins. The 1-1 home.
That's ball two.
Too high that time, and it's 3-1. Turned on that one and crushed it, just pulled it a little foul. Into the windup, ready with the payoff pitch. Line shot to first, and there's one away. So coming to the plate, Ryan Howard. He's 0-2 thus far in this one. The 2-1. And it's fouled away. Bases are empty, one man out. Down the third baseline, but a foul ball as it holds it 2-2. There's a shin-high slider laid off for a ball. Kian Wong is on deck. And a fastball misses there, ball four. Stepping into the box, Kian Wong is working on a 1-for-3 thus far. Wong. Slapped hard the opposite way. In there, a base hit.
Now batter, the catcher, Tyler.
Into the box now, Taylor Heineman. And that's upstairs, running the count to 3-1. And he drops a change in on him there, and that'll run it full, 3-2.
Great job on those last two pitches of varying speeds. Gave him a hard fastball, and then he locked him up with a changeup.
And he takes ball four, so a good job out of the nine hole and getting on base as we go back to the top of the order. Jacob Hayward will be the first to meet him here, and they'll do so in an enviable situation indeed. Bases loaded and only one out now. The 1-1. Swing and a hard liner to center field. McKenna is there, and that should be deep enough to score the run. And the runner scores from third as they extend their lead. It's an 8-3 ball game. Now with the play, Joe McCarthy. He's homered and doubled in four trips, so he's definitely been a factor. Here's the 1-1.
Great chance right here as a hitter to be really aggressive. With two guys already on, pretty good shot. He's going to get a challenge pitch right here.
Swing and a liner. And that's through into left, a base hit. The throw home. But the throw will be well up the line as he scores easily.
Now back, the designated hitter.
To the plate now, Stephen Padilla. Line to the right side. And that's through into right field for a base hit. And a good throw will wind up holding that runner at third, so the bases become loaded now with two gone. Standing in now, Gio Brusa. Grounded back up the middle. And that's through into center field. Base hit. One run is scored. And the second run will score as well. At the plate, number 34. Swing and a ground ball to third. A dive, but it's off his glove. And no chance on the throw here as he reaches first easily. Tyler Irwin comes on to pitch now, hoping for better results than the other arms that they've run out there in this one. So now to the plate, Zach Houchins. Grounder down the line at third. But a foul ball, 1-2 now. Looking to leave him loaded. There's a swing and a drive hit well out to right field. A ball that's carrying. And he makes a nice catch on the track as that ends the inning. All set to start the ninth in this one. And standing in the outfielder, Ryan McKenna. Here's the 1-1. Offered a low one there, but came up empty.
You got to be paying attention as an offense in a hitter's meeting in this situation. When you got a guy on the mound that you know the bottom can drop out of any pitch he throws, you have to elevate your sights.
The 2-2. Pulled high in the air out to left field. Hayward is right there as he puts it away. No problem for the first down. Ready for another shot now. Ryland Bannon. No hits in three tries so far. He struck out once. The 1-1 home. One out, nobody on. Bouncer up the middle, and that'll get on through into center, and he's got himself a one-out hit.
Now batter, the catcher, Taylor Davis.
Into the box, Taylor Davis, and he popped him up. Back into foul territory behind first, but this'll land untouched. Here's the pitch on 2-2. Swing and a liner. Foul. Oh. Got him swinging. Chased it well out of the zone, and there are two gone.
The third baseman, number 13.
Here now is Jose Rondon. He was sat down on strikes in his last at-bat.
Yeah, but it was a good changeup, Matty. Good arm action on that pitch. Look for him to try and stay back a little bit more. Let the ball get a little deeper. Don't be shocked if this pitcher tries to rush a heater right here.
Swing and a miss. He struck him out, and that'll do it here as the ball game is over.
It seemed like everyone had a hand in this win, and that's usually the case when you win a game by 8 runs. Feels good to dominate a game like that.
This one pretty much over before it started as we give you a final look at the line score here in what turned out to be a blowout victory. Every game has its offensive stars, and in this one, he arguably shined the brightest. He's our top player of the game.
Yeah, no question. He was a tough out up there. Ended up collecting 3 knocks, including a home run. So without him in the lineup, I think this might have been a different story.
The final score in this contest. Richmond jump out to a 1-0 series lead. Tyler Anderson earns the victory on the mound. Brian Gonzalez permitted 6 earned runs to come across in the losing effort. So that'll put a wrap on things here this evening. From my partners Dan Plesac and Mark DeRosa, I'm Matt Vaskirjan. This has been a special presentation of MLB The Show. For more, follow us on Twitter at MLB The Show.
Here now is our final line score. First, for your victorious home team, 11 runs, 15 hits, 1 error, they left 8 runners on base. For the Baysox, 3 runs, 5 hits, no errors, they left 5 men on base. Time of the ball game, 3 hours and 38 minutes. Thank you for joining us here tonight. And we remind you to please drive home safely.